G'day, welcome back to Buildsum, and this will be the third video in a little series on calculating and estimating ridge lengths. And in this one we're going to get a little bit more complicated and do a broken hip and valley roof, and I'll have a look at a couple of different situations in here. So with a broken hip and valley roof, you can see there's actually two ridges. There's one on the major part of the roof and one on the minor part of the roof. And you can see there, major ridge, or the ridge for the major span, and the ridge for the minor span. So calculating the ridge for the major span is exactly what we did in the last video. We're just going to deduct the half span of this roof from each end. So the span of the roof's 5 meters, so the half span's 2.5. It's going to take 2.5 meters off there, 2.5 meters off there, and you'll get your length, which would be 7.1 minus 5. It's going to be a 2.1 meter length of ridge, so you would order 2.4. Okay, so that one's pretty simple. This one here is not any harder, it just may look harder, but really, if we can work out the length of this extension, or this part sticking out of our building, that's exactly the same length as our ridge here. So that's reasonably easy. If I just turn on the x-ray tool so we can see where the walls would be. Doesn't matter about our overhangs because they're going to cancel each other out. So 7.5 meters less 5 meters would give us a ridge length here of 2.5 meters. Okay, so again, for estimation you'd order 2.7. that's pretty much cut and dry. However, there's always a but. Some people, when they construct this style of roof, actually run their ridge all the way through. So you can see here on the frame view, here's our intersection. The ridge starts here and it runs all the way through past this intersection to the next rafter, or to our crown end rafter. So it actually comes from the center of that roof through to that intersection. So we obviously need to add this distance here. Now there's a couple of ways you can do that. The probably the easiest way is we can just add, and again I'll turn on the x-ray tool so we can see where the walls are. Alright, so if we take the half span of the main roof, that'll get us to this point. And then if we add the length of the minor roof, that'll get us out to there. And then if we deduct the half span of the minor roof, that'll get us a dimension back to there. So it seems a little bit long-winded, but we can't just take one dimension straight from that line to that point there. So we have to add a couple, take one off. So let's have a look. So 2.5 meters is our half span of this roof. And we already know that 2.5 meters is our extension, or the length of this wall. So 5 meters less the half span of this roof, so half of this figure. 1.841 gives us a ridge length from that intersection to the middle, or that crown end rafter, of 3.159. So you would order a 3.3. Now, if we were going to have a gable roof or gable end, same situation. Okay, the calculation would just be the half span of the major roof plus the length of this extension plus the overhang. So we'd actually end up with a ridge length of 5.582.5. Alright. So that's for a gable end. If the gable went right out to the end of this building, we don't worry about the hips. So some people might be actually wondering, okay, so how do we actually work out how long it, just say for some reason we wanted to know what this distance was. It's really pretty simple. All you need to do is you take the half span of this building, or sorry, this part of the building, so 2.5 meters, minus the half span of this building, this part of the building, which is 1.841, and you'll get a distance of 659 millimeters. Okay, 659 millimeters. So just to test that theory out, let's go back to my hip roof. So 3 meters, 159 minus 659 will give us a length of 2.5 meters, which is what we calculated that length to be in the first place. Okay, so there you go. There's a couple of different ways to calculate the length of a hip roof, a broken hip and valley roof.
G'day again, I'm back. Just to let you know, if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel or follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.